we're in the middle of something over here.
And the show had to start. But listen, it's a fabulous Friday. It's Friday, guys.
Thank goodness.
Yeah. It's sleepy.
This is the second time it's been Friday this week.
I know. It's true.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it feels like it when we came to work yesterday. When did we come to work? Yesterday. And it's like we didn't know where we were or what day it was.
I thought it was Monday.
Something's wrong.
Yeah, and we had that whole discussion about that yesterday. And then I noticed when we watched Chris the Critic do movies yesterday, you said, I saw a good movie over the weekend.
Yes, I did.
Yeah. See, you cannot say. Yeah, it's messed up.
Felt odd. But today's Friday. We've settled that part.
What's happening this weekend? Anybody got some big plans?
No, but we'll be every bit as confused Monday, so don't worry about it. No, I don't know. Over the weekend, I really don't know, although Jamie Warner is over in the weather lab now and is indicating it's going to be a lovely day tomorrow.
Yeah.
Good.
So that's nice.
Lovely as in
my
not
air
as hot
conditioning
today.
Broke.
You mentioned that your air conditioning. Now, is anyone on their way to repair this, or
Monday.
Are you going to just...
Tom!
I am sure that right now they're very busy. I mean, it has been hot, a good stretch, and air conditioning does go out.
You mean you don't have any pole? You don't have any extra pole or something?
No.
Those people out here?
No. Oh, no.
So you came in today and cranked the air down in our office to 60 because I think you were just still hot.
It was 69 degrees.
Too cold.
We were cold, yeah.
They sit in the office all the time going, it's so cold in here, it's so cold.
We are those people.
But he's making up because he doesn't want to go home to his hot house, and I'm sorry about that.
That's all right.
Yeah.
I grew up without air conditioning. I'll survive.
I did, too. Sure. Well, there was such a thing, but my dad didn't turn it on.
Yeah, didn't turn on very much. To come stay in our guest room.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
You can't be nice.
Can't bring all the dogs and everything?
No.
How many dogs do you have?
If you take home a cat, you can bring the dogs.
Ah, that's
all. There
you
go. Take a cat home. You're welcome.
As I said, I'm probably just going to this weekend sit in a bathtub. Sit on cool porcelain.
That sounds good.
Just sit there all weekend long. I don't know. That sounds like it would be interesting.
Yeah.
All right.
I want to get out.
Yeah, me too.
You guys don't have any plans for the weekend?
No, actually, the garden needs to be, the weeds are coming up, and I'm just going to work in the yard. I haven't had any time to do that, and sometimes you just want to stay home.
Should be nice for doing that.
Yeah.
Jamie said it's going to be a nice day tomorrow.
No, I've heard that.
Art walks tonight downtown. Might go to Art Walk for a little bit.
I didn't know
that'd
that.
That'd be a good idea.
That'd be something fun to do.
That would be something
art
fun.
Walk is like always a good time.
Yes, it's always fun. You know,
always great
find.
Music there. Uh-huh. And
lots of food.
I always forget. You need to remind me earlier, 2-3 days before.
Well, you've got a couple hours.
Well,
so
that's true.
You'll make it.
That's
it'll be
true.
Fun. Okay. All right,
don't
like we said, it is finally Friday. No. We're here to help you kick off the weekend. Wireless Trends is in the studio with tips on phone care during the heat. Mm-hmm. We're around water a lot. We need to know what to do if the phone gets wet. Dr. Emily has another incidental for us from Nixidental, but before we get to it, I'm going to show you what is on the radar. Okay, here's a way to get married in style on this Style and Leisure Friday in Las Vegas, the Wedding Chapel at Taco Bell Cantina.
Well, that sounds stylish.
We talked about that on this show. Mm-hmm. We showed this to you about a year ago when they opened, but now Taco Bell is really putting a ring on this idea with more wedding swag. Now there is an online store for couples who are as devoted to Taco Bell as they are devoted to their beloved. You can find these Mr. and Mrs. shirts, his and hers shirts. Jeremy, I found something for him, the sauce packet bow tie. every well-dressed groom needs to look hot on his big day.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. I thought you'd like that. Yep. You can book the wedding chapel in Vegas. It's lovely, by the way. About 60 couples did this last year. And tied the knot at Taco Bell, complete with a Cinnabon wedding cake, which I think sounds and looks delightful, and Taco Bell logoed champagne flutes.
Wow.
Okay. Look at this happy couple walk down the aisle at this savory little chapel of love. They hired a photographer, clearly. They had an absolute blast. I spent several minutes looking at their wedding photos this morning online. Go to TacoBellWeddings.com for more information. Lots of fun photos, and please invite us if you plan to run away to this dream wedding in Vegas.
We can get some good footage on that for sure.
Yeah.
Does Elvis show up or anything?
That's a whole different one.
You know what? I think you bring the person you want to officiate. So if you would like for Elvis to do that, I'm quite sure Taco Bell would say we don't mind that at all.
You take her. You take her down.
Yeah. That was good, Tom.
Thanks.
Well, you know, I have a couple of friends who.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I have a couple of friends, impersonator friends, who have gotten their license to marry people. because they say there's money in that. They say there's a lot of money in
that. Sure there is.
Yeah.
Absolutely there is.
People are looking for something different to do all the time, and that's what my OTR is about.
Okay.
Okay, here, have you guys heard of the new trends for 2018? I know you're really going to be affected by this. Hair trends, Tom. You're excited about that.
Have at it.
Okay, here we go.
He's cutting edge.
All right, some
cutting
of these are
edge.
Being...
That's good.
Some of these are being pulled from years ago, and some, I think, are just ways of doing something outside the box. They're just looking for something different, too.
You're all about hair. What have you got?
Well, scrunchies. Scrunchies are back. Joy, did you ever wear those? Do you remember those?
I did.
Did you really?
Yes, of course.
All right. Well, they are comfortable for sure, and they're easy on the hair, unlike rubber bands that can damage your hair when you put it in and you take it out. So
I'm a fan.
You
I like
are
scrunchies.
A fan?
Sure.
I can make us some of those. All right.
You do that.
Yeah. Now, well, you know, okay, we'll wear them on the show together, okay? Now, this next one really is baffling to me. All right, look how young she is.
It's the gray hair.
It's
thing.
The gray hair. Silver is in, and that is just wonderful. If it's natural, maybe just maybe add a little bit of shine to it. But this look is a full-on prefabricated gray with a metallic finish, and it's being worn by, as you see, very young individuals. I saw someone the other day that had this look, and I automatically think that maybe they're a little older. She turned around just young as can be. I'm not thrilled with this.
The gray hair thing's been around, but real metallic, though.
Metallic is a different thing. Yeah, they're adding a little twist to it with that, okay? Now, if that doesn't float your boat, the braid is back, and it doesn't have to be perfect.
Thank goodness.
You can do it behind your head, and it's all cool. It's the messy braid, and it takes about 2 minutes to accomplish. And if you see this on someone, it may actually have been done on purpose. Remember, it's straight out of the fashion magazine, so that's another one. Now, here we go. Last but not least, headscarves are back, and they are all over the runway. You can find them in stores, or maybe you could find some really cool ones in vintage shops. But the new look is more of an Italian luxe feel than a 40s vibe. They are to be tied flat around the head with a sort of antique pattern to them. So those are interesting. But those are a few ideas for you. There's other trends like blue hair, which I'm not crazy about. Rose gold hair is kind of pretty. Barrettes, hair bands, you know, some I get, some I don't. Styles come and go. And I remember when my grandma, you remember when the real straight hair came in?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. My grandma would always she hated that. She wanted me to go get a perm right away. So we all have our thoughts.
Everybody has their, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to make a scrunchie for Tom, too, when I make one for us.
I can't.
What color would you like for your mustache? Blue. You look good in blue.
Okay.
Okay. Just so you know.
Whistling.
Okay.
Can be happy, jaunty, you know, carefree way to pass the time. Just making like the birdies and tweeting your favorite melody. Well, according to a survey by YouGov, the proportion of people finding the lilting pastime to be annoying has increased. 47% of people polled find it irritating, and that figure rose to 53% among 18 to 24-year-olds. This suggests that whistling may die out as the years pass. In fact, the decline in whistling may have already begun, with 87% over 60 saying they're hearing whistling less than they used to. Now, I'm over 60, and that just may be a function of your hearing.
I wonder.
The question is why. The thought is that whistling is an absent-minded thing we do in idle moments, and with our faster-paced world, we just don't have time for that kind of idle stuff. Another thought is with so much modern technology, we just don't have that kind of time to just blow away.
I get it. Now, who spent money and time on that little survey, I wonder?
I don't know.
You know, there are surveys for everything. It was probably chapstick or something. Yeah.
Can you whistle?
Sometimes I can.
I'm not a good whistler.
Like, and then if I work on it, but I whistle crooked. I whistle like off to the side rather than straight. And I've never been able to.
I've always wanted
do
to
that
I've
kind
always
of thing.
Wanted to learn that too, and I can't do it.
People
who do it well are very effective.
Yeah.
Very effective.
I always like to see a girl do that.
Oh, I know. It's
I
impressive.
I just wish I could do that, yeah.
Years ago, I interviewed the girl who played Ellie Mae.
And she could do that?
Oh, my gosh. Did you break your eardrums?
Oh, wow. That'd
she was really good at
for
it.
Sure.
That is one of those things I'd like to learn to do. Yeah. It's so effective.
You can take lessons. They have them on YouTube, I think.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Good.
All right, coming up, it's another Build It Better project. Don't go away. Ozarks Live is just getting started.